place you here.
What's good, YouTube? The Black Okage here, aka TBH, and to be honest, I'm here to discuss Transformers Devastation. Interesting game. Kinda came out of nowhere around E3, and it was developed by Platinum Games, which means we could get another classic like Bayonetta 2, or it could be another horrific Legend of Korra game. So naturally, this game was met with a lot of skepticism. Well, I'm here to let you guys know. Breathe easy, gamers. Transformers Devastation, not bad.
A little to the left. A smidge more. That's got it.
Will you never learn, Megatron?
Story.
Who reading a book?
Alright, look. Megatron discovers a way to turn Earth into a metal form. Basically, he wants to turn Earth into Cybertron 2.0. But Optimus Prime was like, oh, hell nah, that shit ain't cool. So then Bumblebee comes through like, pew, pew, pew. Start screaming for ice cream. But then Sideswipe was like, don't start no stuff, won't be no stuff. But all jokes aside, that didn't really happen. Megatron really did find a way to turn the Earth into metal. But the Autobots weren't having that. That's the story. No, really. The story is fucking worthless in this game. It is forgettable. That is the best way to describe the cutscenes. Forgettable.
Gameplay. Sway.
Transformers Devastation is a linear beat-em-up that's not as deep as Bayonetta 2, but it's nowhere near as shallow as The Legend of Korra. You get 5 Autobots to play: Optimus Prime, Bumblebee, Sideswipe, Wheeljack, and Grimlock. Each have their own special abilities, but you'll mostly be playing as one because the game is so short, it's pointless trying to upgrade them all. In Devastation, you'll move to the objective on the map where either a fight with some minions breaks out, or a cutscene plays, then a boss fight. It's absolutely nothing original about the mission structure in this game. Where the game does shine is in its combat. Devastation uses a simple light and heavy attack combo system where your moves vary depending on what weapon you choose to go into a mission with. You have the option to choose a primary hand-to-hand weapon such as swords, gloves, hammers, and more, plus you have secondary long-range weapons for shooting down flying-type transformers. Devastation is all about timing. If you manage to pull off a multiple-hit combo, you'll be given the option to continue your combo with a rush move where your transformer turns into a car and he bum-rushes the enemy. You combine that with your special move and you can create some very long combos that make you feel like a badass. When it comes to the defense, the roll mechanic is everything. Dodge at the right time and time slows down, giving you the option to start your combo and punish the enemy. It's not just the combat that's fast paced either. Driving around the map is fast paced and overall the pacing of the game is too. It seems like there's a lot of boss fights. I mean, there's a boss fight or a mini boss fight every few minutes. The game does a great job of constantly introducing new high ranking Decepticons that you have to fight. I'd say the highlight of the game are the boss fights. Platinum knows how to do boss fights and they killed it again in Transformers. There were levels in the game where I had to fight 3 separate bosses at 3 separate times in that same level, but then at the end of the level, you had to fight all 3 at once, and some would even combine like Voltron. It makes for a fun game, and it's very satisfying and challenging, and it keeps you on your toes.
What I hated. No sweat.
I read online that this game is only 6 hours long. Well, I beat it in 5. 5 hours. I repeat, 5 hours, guys. That's absolutely unacceptable for a $50 game. The fact that they even made it $50 instead of $60 says to me that they knew there was a lack of content in this game. The worst part of all is I honestly feel like this game only has 3.5 hours worth of content. It only took 5 hours for me to beat it because some of the boss fights are legit pull your hair out hard. If those boss fights weren't there, I'm willing to bet you'd only have about 3 hours worth of content. Outside of the game's length, I fucking hated that Dinobot retard Grimlock. The other 4 Autobots, they can naturally combo due to their speed and their car form, but because Grimlock isn't a car, he's worthless when it comes to combos, and they didn't compensate him by making him stronger or something, so instead, you'll be chasing your enemies on foot like a dumbass. Imagine a dinosaur fighting Starscream.
Why y'all got me doing this? Got fucking Barney chasing a damn spaceship. This don't make no damn sense. I look fucking stupid, dog.
Final verdict. Sway.
I had a good time playing Transformers Devastation, and if you go into with the right expectations, I think you can too. It's a middle-of-the-road, B-level type game that could have been so much more, but ultimately, it's just too pricey for the amount of content you're getting. Final recommendation, if you're interested, only pick it up when the price drops, and I'm talking about really drops. This game isn't worth more than $20 due to lack of content, and that's a damn shame because the gameplay is cool. And those are my thoughts on Transformers Devastation. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below, and when you're finished, make sure to check out GamingIlluminati.com. We are the Enlightened Gamers, so come through and enlighten yourself on the latest things going on in the gaming industry. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, but my village needs me.